Listen up, for the next 30 days, I'm going to attempt to eat, train, and sleep like Michael B. Jordan. This is an experiment that I wanted to try when the first film came out. But at that time I was a lot younger and I didn't know anything about the gym. So why am I doing this challenge right now? As you guys know, I'm already pumping out some videos about self-improvement and lifestyle and fitness. But who is better in the self-improvement journey than Michael B. Jordan himself? Y'all already know that Lori Harvey broke up with him and this viral clip went around. But it looked like it didn't faze him. For the first Creed movie, he got even leaner and bigger, all while producing the film. And even though he already had the status of most sexiest man alive, he still kept on improving himself. And he definitely didn't achieve this overnight. Look where he came from. I have so much respect for the man. So that's why I also wanted to try this. Wish me luck, because this is gonna be a hard one. Before I could start the challenge, I had to figure out what Michael was doing to get in such great shape. Some different sites say some different things, so it was a bit of a challenge to figure out how he did this. So I thought to myself, what's better than to listen to the man himself? So I opened YouTube and searched for Michael B. Jordan workout routine. I watched some different videos, but then I finally found the key on how he got this big.
Like literally grilled chicken, broccoli, 1.5 gallons of water a day.
Diet for me, honestly, chicken, broccoli, a lot of water.
Broccoli, rice, and chicken. How? There's no way it's that simple. But he said it himself, so I guess this is the way. He obviously has the best chefs in the world, and I only have myself. And I can tell you guys, I can't cook. What? George, you do have a channel where you talk all about self-improvement, and you don't even know how to cook? There's a time for everything, guys. Don't judge me on this one. Luckily, I still have my mom who can help me with some dishes to get my protein in for the day. And that's the most important thing. To build more muscle and to look leaner, you have to get your protein in. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. Now that we've got the nutrition covered, I needed to focus on his training split. His trainer says he does one cardio session and one resistance training session a day. And on top of that, he also does boxing almost every single day. After a few hours of research, I knew this whole challenge was going to be tough. But I think I'm up for it. Before we start, let's go over some stuff. Over the next 30 days, I expect to lose some weight. Not that much, but maybe just a little bit. I also expect to look a little bit leaner and also to have gained a bit more muscle. By the way, definitely subscribe if you haven't already, because I put a lot of time in this project and that's the best cost-free way you can support this channel so I can make more content like this. Without further ado, let the games begin. I've woken up early in the morning, and before I even started to think about going to the gym, I first had to know what my starting point was. At the first weigh-in, I was 84.9 kilograms, with my body looking like this. For sure, it wasn't bad, but I knew I had so much more in the tank. I could get more defined shoulders, I also wanted to get my abs to show a little bit more, and just look more toned. So that's what we're aiming for. The first day started well, with a good breakfast in the morning, I made some eggs, and I also got a glass of milk for the extra protein, and also this delicious cookie, who was staring at me the whole time, and I knew I couldn't eat.
I can't have this right now.
And after my breakfast, I went to work. I work at a sports shop where I also walk and lift a lot. So that's the biggest benefit that I have with my busy working schedule when it comes to this challenge. In my lunch, I made a toasty and also ate some bread with peanut butter. After that, I worked for a few more hours and went home to get some extra energy from the dinner that my mom made.
So we're finally going to eat, and I think this will give me the energy to go hard.
My mom made this and it looks delicious. Oh.
I got some cauliflower with a special sauce on it, and also some potatoes and a pork steak. See you in a bit.
But then it was time for the serious business. The first workout of this challenge. After that, I already was a little bit tired, but then the real deal began, the boxing session.
Man, you crazy. See, it ain't easy being me. Life as a celebrity is less than heavenly. I got these fakes and these backstabbers chasing me around, and it's always drama. Whenever I want to get around, mama told me, long before I ever came up, gotta be true to what you do and keep the game up. Cause things change, and jealousy becomes a factor. Best friends at your wife's house trying to match.
had to go to the toilet every 30 minutes during the night. This was because I drank so much water in the training session that I had the night before. It was horrible. So the rest that I thought I was getting was completely thrown out the window. But we had to keep on going. So I went to the gym the next morning to do a cardio session. I've cycled for a bit and after that I went home to make some breakfast. This time I made some cooked eggs for the protein and I also made a protein shake. This day I also had to go to work, so I was grinding again and my step counter on my watch was going up, up and up. In the evening I got myself some dinner and went to the gym to do a pool session. The training was alright, but I was definitely noticing the lack of sleep that I got the night before. The next few days my schedule was very similar. I woke up, did some cardio in the gym, went home, ate a good high protein breakfast, rushed to work, rushed back home, ate some dinner, and did my resistance training or boxing workout in the evening. A few days passed and everything felt okay. I noticed that I was getting used to the schedule and that my body was handling it well. I wanted to switch things up a little bit. I did some low intensity cardio in the days before, but I was noticing that my system was up for the next challenge. So instead of the low intensity cardio, this time I went for a run.
Let's go. Let's keep on pushing. It's a little bit rainy outside right now, but that doesn't stop us. We have to keep on going.
The motivation wasn't that great. It was harder to get out of bed and the training session wasn't that amazing. I needed to get a boost, but how? Watching the movie, of course. It was premiere day, so I went to the cinema with my friends on the day it came out. And I can tell you guys, the movie is amazing. If you haven't watched it yet, you should definitely do it. The way the story is set up, I instantly had more energy to get on with the challenge.
So it's a rest day for me right now. It's a beautiful weather outside. Look at the sun. Over there. Amazing. Yeah, I really love this because when I have a rest day, I want to do something like walking or stretching, and not doing something at all makes me feel really lazy. So that's why I swear there's nothing better than walking outside when the weather is this good. Good morning! It's day 15 of the challenge right now, so we're going to do a weigh-in. I'm really excited to see what my body has been up to, because for the last 15 days I've been training well, and my nutrition was also okay.
What? Only lost 300 grams? Can't be.
The thing is that the scale doesn't say everything, because I've lost a little bit of weight, and that's okay because we don't want to rush things. So the most important thing that we're going to see at day 30 is the body composition and the difference in that. So that's definitely something we have to keep in mind.
For the next week, I wanted to step it up, especially on the cardio side. I did some more walking, some more cycling, and also some more group training, because yes, I also give group workouts in my gym. This is a mix between cardio and resistance training, so for this challenge, it was an amazing way to burn some extra calories and look more defined. I was feeling great, at least I thought so. The boxing sessions went alright, but there's something way more special about boxing than regular exercise. Because you're always in your zone, you're not focused on the things around you. You're trying to be in the moment and focus on what is. This is definitely not easy to do, and after a few weeks of training it got the better of me. You're fighting your own demons and your own past. When you're stuffing all your thoughts up in your own body and when you start thinking about them while you're hitting the bag, it can sometimes be too much.
Oh, I'm shaking so much. Holy shit.
Oh. The next day I picked myself up. I reflected on all the frustrations that were coming out the night before. I wrote them down and let go of them. It's so much better to let it all out sometime. This challenge gave me so many different insights in how we can cope with our problems and past and not run from it, but fight it. That's the mentality that I created right now.
Definitely after this challenge, I'm still going to do this. Wow.
The day before the final results, I wanted to get every single bit out of this last day of training. I woke up early so I could go for a walk, made a high protein breakfast for the last time, and you never guessed it, went to work. It was a long day. I had to work from 10 until 6 in the evening, but it felt good all day. I knew these were the last steps that I had to take to complete this challenge. After work, I immediately went home and went to the gym to give it my all in the final boxing session.
Thank you.
When I first started this challenge, I didn't have any clue about what to expect and what the possibilities were after 30 days of hard work and training. But now we will see what these 30 days have brought me, not only on the scale, but especially in my physique. Here we go. 30 days of training and eating like Michael B. Jordan has given us this physique. I'm actually quite happy. I have the feeling that I've gotten a bit leaner, but the thing that I'm most stoked about is the development of my shoulders and my chest. This is a huge difference from when I started this challenge, so I'm actually very pleased with the results. And the physical changes were not the only thing that I was happy about, but I was also very amazed by the changes that boxing made up here. I think this is something that everyone has to consider, and I'm definitely not a professional boxer right now, but I think it has definitely leveled me up in some sense. I really enjoyed this challenge, and also the making of the video and the whole process around it. If you also like this video, then definitely don't forget to subscribe. It would mean the world to me, and let me know if you have any tips, because feedback is good. This is the first time that I'm making such a video. We're looking to improve ourselves every single day, because that's our main goal on this channel. So let's do everything about it to achieve this. Thank you so much for watching.